and cooperation by supporting the student athletes.
Last month, as they are near the bottom of the Northeast Division at 3-9 overall in the NE10, 8-9 overall. Jackets 10-10, 5-7 in the NE10. Right in the midst of a playoff appearance, as right now they lead Pace and St. Rose by one game, but they do trail Lemoyne, Southern Connecticut by a couple games. They're 8-4, 8-5 respectively. AIC at 5-7. A win today would do wonders for their record and hopefully their playoff aspirations. So it'll be Jackets jumping here with Kamika Mason. She'll be in the middle as Jackets go left to right towards Roosevelt Avenue, if you're familiar with the area. Tip is won by AIC over Maggie Sabine, so it'll be Jacket ball here. Man-to-man by the Purple Knights. Roach dribbling the ball. Passes here to the right side, Bishop. 2-3, making a 2-3 zone here by St. Mike's as Stephanie dribbles down along the baseline, throws it off glass, and she puts it home for two. Jackets will pick up full court zone press, 2-2-1 zone. And here's Lemoyne. In the backcourt, here's Sabine. They'll go all the way over the top here to the left to Akipa tonight. And she'll slow it down with Godreau. Godreau here to the right. Sabine back to Godreau. Godreau gets it to Sabine here along the right side. Now top of the key to Burbert. And to the left side, a jumper's long from Godreau. Rebound in the corner picked up by Ferrandino. Bishop will bounce it to Ferrantino. She'll pull up from the free throw line. Shot short. Rebound grabbed by Mason, and she'll muscle it in for two more. 4-0 Jackets. Sabine here in the backcourt. Now to the right side. She'll get the Godreau. Back to Sabine. They quickly rotate it to the left side to Frappier. Frappier over the top to the right finds Godreau, who dribbles, drives. Nice pass down low. The shot's no good from Burud, and the rebound picked up by Stephanie. Cookie to the right side, here's Bishop. She'll leave it for Roach. Down the lane, right side, leaves it for Bishop. Looking for dribbles and out to the top of the key. Now to the right side, back to Bishop. Left side, Stephanie. Into the corner, Ferrantino. She finds a cutting Roach. Down the lane, back out to Ferrantino. Steps to her left, takes the long jumper and hits. 6-0 Jackets. She showed some great touch here over the last few games. Hitting that outside shot makes her very effective and hard to guard on the offensive end. Acquitate. We'll leave it here for Sabine. Or excuse me, for Godreau. Now to Sabine to the right side and into the corner. Frappier. She'll take a few dribbles. Find Sabine. Over the top. We'll get it out to Godreau. Thought about shooting. She didn't. Now to the right side, Sabine. Steps in. Takes a 15-footer. No good off the front iron. Rebound on the weak side. Picked up. And a foul will be called on St. Mike's. It'll be the first team foul on them. It'll be Jack of Ball. The foul will be on Mackenzie Brood. Left side, Stephanie. Into the corner, Ferrantino. They stay in the 2-3 zone. Bishop, now to the right, Stephanie. Into the corner, Ferrantino. She'll take a long jumper just inside the arc, and she hits it again. 8-0 Jackets. Brood. This is for Godreau. Godreau here to the right side, Sabine. Over the top, quickly to Acquitate. Julie for Sabine. Now they'll pass to the left side. Down low they find Barut. Along the left block, she'll throw up a tough shot. It's long, and the rebound's picked up by Ferrandino. Roach, quickly the other way. Gets it to Bishop, right side. Dribbled. Try about driving. She did it. And they'll slow it back down. Quickly to the left, Stephanie. Find Mason. Mason will take a dribble in. Takes the 10-footer and hits it off glass. Timeout. 10-0 Jackets here with 16:52 to go in the first half. Jackets taking a commanding quick lead, and the Purple Knights will talk it over on the sidelines as the Jackets haven't really given St. Mike's anything easy on the offensive end, and the Jackets themselves on the offensive end have been very efficient, hitting just about every shot they have taken, and it's been keyed by Ferrantino, who's been red hot to start. She's hit a couple of shots now from almost the three-point arc, just inside the arc. Really showing her range and her confidence to take that shot here early on. And again, that has helped her really put a great season here to this year. She's always been a bit able to hit from outside, but just not to the efficiency that she's been able to do it this year. especially of late. She's really been working on that shot. So that certainly helping the Jackets and their offensive attack. When they've missed, the Jackets have been able to get offensive rebounds. As Mason's been on the boards a few times now on the offensive end. So everything going well so far for the Jackets. Everett will check in here for St. Mike's. In the backcourt, a little over the top to Akpedit. She'll dribble in, down the lane, throws up a shot off glass, and she hits it. And it makes it an 8-point deficit now as they get their first points of the game. Got a matchup man-to-man on this possession as Roach crosses the timeline. She'll dribble to the right side, bounces it to Bishop. She'll step to her left, takes the long 20-footer. It's short off the front iron. Rebound picked up by Godrow. Godrow pushes it up the left side to Sabine. Leaves it back out to Godrow. No one going to guard her. She'll step in and take a 20-footer. No good off the back iron. Rebound tipped into the hands of Bishop. Roach here between the circles, guarded by Barut. Bounces it to Mason at the right elbow. Takes a dribble to the left. Now goes all the way down the left part of the lane. Throws it off glass. It's a bit strong. Rebound tipped into Mason. She'll go up strong. Again, a little strong. Weak side board put up and... don't know if she's going to get credit for the shot or not as Ferentino was fouled. They're going to say on the floor. The state jacket ball. Everett will pick up the foul. Her first. Team second. Get out to Bishop here along the right side. Top of the key, Ferentino. Drives down the left part of the lane. Steps back. The shot's an air ball. Loose ball picked up though by Mason. She'll muscle it up and put it in for two. 12-2 Jackets. Godrow over the top. Gets it to Barud. She'll dribble down the right side. Pull up from the baseline. 15-footer is short. Rebound though. Put back is good by Sabine. Her first deuce of the game. She led the Purple Knights in scoring the last time these two teams met last year. She cuts the lead down to 8. Roach, here along the right side, bounces to Stepney, top of the key. Finds a wide open Mason, lower right block, and she'll put it in for two more. 14-4, Jackets with 15:05 to go. Over the top here, left side, Akpedit. She'll dribble, drive, another floater in the lane, short off the front iron, but the loose ball will go out to Goodrow. And they'll reset. Here to the right side, Evra, dribble, drive. Reverse lane is way off the mark, but she got hit on the face. Bailed out, and she'll get herself two at the line.
Yellow jacket foul on number 33, Kamika Mason. First person.
Fouls on Mason, her first. Team's first as well. Free throws off the front iron and no good. For Evra, she'll get one more. Evra, 5'7 sophomore from Summersville. Second free throw is good, so it's a 14-5 game now with 14:48 to go. Jackets leading. Man-to-man as Roach crosses the timeline. Tepley on the floor for AIC as well. Tarantino, left side, finds Easter. She'll take an 18-footer, no good. Rebound battle for and picked up by Barud. Barud up the right sideline, pushing it up the floor. Has some numbers, leaves it for Everett. She'll fire a three. Her shot's no good. Weak side board picked up by Ferentino. Roach looking to push. Has some players up ahead. She gets it to Bishop here along the right. She'll bounce it to Ferentino. Trying to find some room. She can't, and it'll kick it out for AIC. Roach. Man-to-man by St. Mike's. 15 on the shot clock. Bishop to the right. Goes to her left around a screen. Leaves it off for Tepley. Tepley squares up. Pass Ferentino. Her man jumps the pass. Doesn't get it, and Ferentino goes in for a lay-in off glass. 16-5. Godrow. Over the top, right side, finds Evra. Into the corner, they get to Sabine. Finds a cutting Evra. To the basket, reverse lanes, an air ball. Rebound by Easter. Last time she got bailed out, not this time. Roach, right side, finds Bishop. Transition three is good. Another timeout taken by St. Mike's. The Jackets have come out storming here. 19-5 lead with 13:37 to go in the first half. Credit some good defense, and offensively, they're just Jackets are hitting their shots, and when they haven't hit their shots, they've been able to get offensive rebounds. and easy putbacks, a ton of offensive boards as the AR eating up the glass. And St. Mike's is just giving up way too many easy baskets, both inside and second chance opportunities. Offensively, St. Mike's hasn't looked very good either. They've got a few baskets on the break, and or mini break if you call it, as they break in the press. But other than that, in the half court, they have not looked very good. Still haven't really seen any moments of magic from Mackenzie Brurud. She leads the team in scoring 16 points per game, shoots over 50% from the field, 47% from beyond the arc. Very good player, you know, seven boards as well, but really has been non-existent here in the early going. The only thing you worry is if this is coming too easy for the Jackets. They take their foot off the pedal and let St. Mike's get back into this. Backcourt, Goodrow. Over at top, finds Brurud. She'll quickly get here to the left side, Frappier. We'll pass it back out to Goodrow. Or Goodrow. Goodrow, right side, Evra. Back to Goodrow. Finds Brurud at the free throw line. She'll take a few dribbles out. Right side, Evra. Down low, baseline, Sabine, out to Frappier. Takes a few dribbles herself, picks up her dribble, finds Brurud. In on the shot clock, she'll fire for three, and she hits. 19-8 with 13:08 to go. Roach into the forecourt. Left sideline. Goes to her right around a screen. They switch out on her, and she'll get it out to Bishop. Back to Roach. Top of the key, Dorsett. Roach looking down low for Tepley. She'll bounce it into her. Tepley goes to the basket, throws it up glass, no good. Rebound grab by Sabine. To the right side, Brurud. Brurud, top of the key, Goodrow. Goodrow will pass to Frappier in the corner. Bounces into Sabine, will hand it back out to Evra. In the corner, Brurud. She'll pass it down low, but it's stolen by Easter. Great hands. Easter trying to go up the floor, and she'll slow it down for AIC. Hit it back out to Bishop. Bishop will call a play here with 20 on the shot clock. Dribbles in, and she's going to pull up for three. No good off the back iron. And rebound will picked up by Dorsett. She'll take a dribble and put in a little four-footer from the block. 21-8. Brurud now to the left side. Goodrow back to Brurud. Over at top, right side, Evra. Into the corner, Sabine. She finds Brurud. Kicks out. Goodrow. Back to Brurud. Oh, it looked like she traveled. No call. Certainly looked like a double dribble as the ball hung up there near her waist, but she gets the basket. And cuts the lead down to 11. Roach. Bounces it to Easter. Easter. Between the circles. Left side to Bishop. Now low to Dorsett. She'll throw it up last from the block, and she hits it. 23-10 Jackets. Goodrow. Along the right sideline. Over the top. Finds Evra. Evra into the corner to Frappier. She'll pass. Finds Brurud. Now to the right side. Goodrow. Take a few dribbles in. Looks up high down low for Frappier. Has position, and her left-handed shot is no good as it rims out. Rebound to Dorsett. Bishop into the forecourt. Calls out a play here as she holds up between the circles. Right side finds Roach. Roach to her left with a couple of dribbles. Pulls up in the paint. Shots in and out and tipped to Frappier. Roach down the backcourt. Steals the pass from Frappier and then gets held up for a jump ball. Looked like that should have been a foul as Frappier went over Roach, but gets the benefit of the doubt. We jump ball and Purple Knight will get possession. Brurud passes in here to Blanche. Blanche back to Brurud against the press and over to the right side to Apkindade. Apkindade along the sideline, now to the left side. Finds Evra in the corner. Blanche. She'll find Brurud along the block. She's doubled and gets it back out to Blanche. Blanche will go left to right, finds a cutter. It's Bennett who dribbles off her foot and it's stolen by Easter. Easter up the right sideline, has people come from behind her and picks up the foul, the over-aggressive Bennett. It'll be jacket ball. First foul on Bennett, the third on St. Mike's. They'll dump it into Dorsett. She'll kick it out to Roach. 10 minutes in the first half remaining. Roach to the left side. Crosses over. Down the lane. Pulls up from the baseline. Shot rattles in and out. Weak side board, though, picked up by Easter. Her pass is going to be stolen by Appendeed. Along the left side, one-on-one on the break. Throws it up and lays it in for two. 23-12. Right side, Stepney. Gives it out top of the key to Mason. Mason takes a few dribbles, leaves for Easter along the left hash. Top of the key to Roach. She'll fire the three. No good from the top of the arc. Rebound picked up by Dorsetta, and she'll get herself two at the line. And she's had a great few minutes here for AIC. Four quick ones and a chance now to make it a couple more here at the free throw line. Fouls the fourth on St. Mike's. The first on Tommy Akinpadid. Dorsett's free throw is good. Jackets doubling up. The Purple Knights 24-12 as Holland will check in for AIC. Second free throw from Dorsett is also good. Roach, Fiorentino will come onto the floor. 6 points for Dorsett off the bench, and she extends the lead to 13 for AIC now. Berrude in the backcourt. Against the press. He'll go now to the left side. And they go over the top to Evra. Now right side, Akmadi. Pull up from the baseline is a short. Rebound on the weak side by Stephanie. And Stephanie will push it up the floor for the Jackets. Here to the right side. Stephanie crosses over around a screen. Looks high down low. A bit too high for Mason. And it's stolen by the Purple Knights. Evra here along the right sideline with the dribble. Top of the key to Berrude. Berrude goes to her left around a screen. Nothing there, though. Leaves it for Akmadid. Down low to Bennett. She throws it up. It's blocked by Mason out of play. It'll stay Purple Knight ball. Godrell will check in for the Purple Knights. Replace Evra. Godrell to pass it in. On the baseline, a little bit of trouble, gets it to Appetite and back out to Gajo. She'll dribble through the paint, throws him a tough shot, it's in and out, rebound grabbed by Fiorentino. Bishop, will slow it up here, into the forecourt. Man-to-man by St. Mike's as she takes it here to the right side, now to the left around a couple of screens. Steps back, leaves for Fiorentino. Into the corner, finds Stepney. Back to Fiorentino along the right hash. She'll dribble, drive. And draw the foul. It'll be on Akmadid. Her second, the team's fifth, and it'll be AIC ball.
Her second personal fifth on the team.
Bishop from the lower right baseline. Goes over the top and into Stephanie. Back to Bishop to call out a play here. 26 on the shot clock. Bishop, left side to Holland. Holland will pivot to her right, falls to the floor, but maintains the dribble. He's tied up, and it'll be a jump ball. And it'll go back to AIC on the change of arrow.
Ball possession.
Shot clock will be at 15. Be Holland to pass it in from the upper sideline. Gets there to Bishop. Down low to Mason. Mason to her right, throws it off glass, and she puts it in for two. 27-12, a great first half here for Mason. Over at the top to find Berrude. She'll pivot and get it nicely here to Gaudreau. Now over at the top, back to Berrude. See if he dribbles out and slow it down for the Purple Knights. Left side Berrude, back to Gaudreau. She finds Bennett, takes a couple dribbles in, but she double dribbled. She picked up her dribble and thought she could go at it again, so it'll be jack of ball in the turnover. Good here to Bishop. 7:22 to go in the first half. It's Jackets 27, Purple Knights 12. Left side to Holland. Top of the key. I'll leave it out for Bishop. Thought about shooting. Says she gets it to Stephanie along the baseline. Takes a step in. Pull up from the paint is good. 29-12. Over the top and it's stolen by Holland. Holland dribbles here to the corner and slows it down and gets it back out to Bishop. A new shot clock here for Bishop. Right side to Stephanie. This is out for Mason. Mason will go inside to Ferentino. Power dribble to the right. Throws it off glass. It's a bit short. And the rebound by Frappier. And he'll slow it down with Gaudreau. Gaudreau here. Left side. Now to the top of the key to Blatch. Man-to-man by AIC. And a foul. It's going to be on Stephanie.
Yellow jacket foul number 5.
Only the second team foul on AIC, though. And first on Stephanie. Jackets fall in a 2-3 zone now. Sabine into the corner. Finds Blatch. She'll pull up for three. It's an air ball. Weak side board is out of play to AIC. .6:20 to go. Jackets leading 29-12. There's Bishop. Bishop will leave it off here to the left side for Holland. Holland will go to her right around the screen. Holding up between the circles. And in the left side, she'll get to Stephanie. She travels before she puts it on the floor. And it'll go back to the Purple Knights. Right side, Evra. Slows it up here and gets it to Goodrow. Jackets stay in the 2-3 zone. Baroud, 2-3 dribbles, long, picks up along the baseline, leaves it for Frappier. Frappier back to Goodrow, left to right with a dribble. And back to Evra, 9 on the shot clock. Baroud moves to her left, they switch out on her. Picks a dribble up along the baseline, gets it out to Goodrow. She'll fire a long three from the right side. It's an air ball, rebound by Bishop. Bishop has a 3-on-3 down the lane. Gets it out to Roach. Open three. She'll fire. No good from the top of the key. Rebound picked up by Evra. She now has a 3-on-2 down the right part of the lane. All the way through and you'll put it off glass for two. 29-14. Roach. Right side. Looking, bounce to the top of the key to Ferentino. Now to the right to Roach. Down low, Tepley. Along the baseline, pumped, thought about shooting, and it's hit away by Frappier. Regathers, goes up strong, but she travels before the shot. And it'll be Purple Knight ball. Baroud. And quickly over to the right side, Evra. Evra, dribble drive by Ferentino. Down the lane, kicks it out, left side, Frappier, a three on the way, is good. Right, I can say a foe's on the line, so it's only a two. And Coach Hutchins is going to take a timeout, it's 29-16 with 4:32 to go. Purple Knights hanging in there and cutting into that lead ever so slightly. Still a 13-point lead for AIC, so they're still comfortably in the lead, but not playing with that dominant swagger that we saw them playing earlier on today, hitting the outside shots and working the ball inside. They've been a little bit lackadaisical on the offensive end, and I'm sure Coach Hutchinson is going to remind their team that St. Mike's can come back. They're still a good team, so. Get it here to Roach. Roach left side to Easter. Easter dumps it down low. Ferentino. Baseline jumper is good. 31-16 AIC. Over to the top and they get it to Evra against the press to find Sabine. He'll dribble to the corner. Kicks it out top of the key to Gaudreau. To Baroud. And she'll dribble back out to Gaudreau. Gaudreau down low to Frappier in the paint. Drops a bump. But she travels and it'll be AIC ball. Roach will bring up the ball along the center of the floor. Man to man by St. Mike's. Left side to Easter. Top of the key, Tapley. Tapley three dribbles. Picks up a dribble. Looking and now to Roach. Roach to her right. Step out on her. Leaves it out for Bishop now. She'll pull up from the right side. The three is up and good. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Her second of the first half. 34-16 AIC. Baroud over the top. Finds Evra at midcourt. She'll leave it here to the right. Gaudreau. Gaudreau picks up a dribble. Back out to Evra. She'll fire a long three. It's way off the mark. Rebound tips. It'll go out of play though. Last touch by Tepley. And we'll stay St. Mike's ball. Get in over top to Baroud. Baroud will take a few dribbles into the paint, throws it up off the glass, and she scores for two. 34-18. There's Roach. Is that top of the key to Easter? Easter will look into the corner, finds Bishop. Another open three. She hits another one. It's three first half threes, and the Jackets now lead 37-18. Baroud over top, right side, Gaudreau. Goes down low to Bennett, who finds Sabine. He'll pull up from the baseline, is no good. Rebound grabbed by Ferentino. Ferentino's going to push it for AIC. She has a one-on-one down the right part of the lane. Throws it up. It's a little short. Rebound up into the hands of AIC. Roach. Into the corner to Easter. Back to Roach. Easter hands off to Bishop. Baroud, challenger, almost gets a steal. Loose ball, still now picked up by the Jackets. Get the Ferentino. She goes to the hoop, almost loses it. Looking, gets out to Mason, and it's going to be stolen by Bennett. 1:57 to go in the first half. Jackets by 19. Right side, Baroud. Out to keep Bennett. Oh, bounce it down low to Sabine. Along the block. Actually travels before the shot, and it'll be AIC ball. Roach. Swing it here to the left side. Looking down low, they find Roach. From the block, she'll go up and will draw a foul. We got ourselves two at the line.
St. Michael's foul on number 33, Indira Laura, her second personal. Sixth on the team.
Free throw's good, so Roach will get one more. Second free throw's good as well. Jackets now lead by 21, 39-18. Gaudreau here to the left side finds Bennett. Bennett trapped at the sideline, but will draw a push on AIC. The 13th foul on the Jackets.
Yellow jacket foul on number 30, on Easter, her first.
It's on Easter, her first. Gaudreau. Pass it in here to Evra. Jackets in a 2-3 zone. They got a 3-2 zone. Baroud in the corner finds Evra. Evra out to Baroud. They're going to get a foul. It'll be on Ferentino down low, away from the ball. It's only the 14th foul on AIC. First on Ferentino. There's Goodrow to pass it in from the baseline. Finds Sabine. Back out to Goodrow in the corner. She'll fire for three. It's an air ball. Rebound picked up by Bennett. Her shot's off the mark, and the rebound into the hands of Easter. Roach quickly going to the other way. And then numbers, he's out for Bishop. Down low to Mason. Along the block, makes her move, kicks out to Bishop. She'll fire for three. This one's a little bit short, and the rebound picked up by Bennett. Under a minute to go. Evra, right side, Goodrow. Goodrow passed down low for Bennett, but the ball is stolen by Mason as she jumped the route. About 10-second differential between shot clock and game clock. Here's Roach. Left side to Easter. And a draw foul. That'd be on Goodrow, a bit too close. 17 foul, and it'll send Easter to the line for 1-1. Stephanie will check in. She replaced Bishop. Easter's free throw is good. She'll get one more. Second free throw is in and out and grabbed by Baroud. Baroud into the forecourt. He's for Bennett. Bennett to the right for Goodrow. Goodrow dumps it down low to Sabine from the lower left block. Her shot is off the mark. Rebound grabbed by Ferrandino. About 12 seconds to go for AIC. Roach comes up the center of the floor. 7 seconds. Roach to her left. Down the lane. Runner off glass is a bit off the mark. Rebound is picked up by Mason, but they're unable to get a shot off. As the half will end with the Jackets up 40-18, a commanding first half for AIC. We'll see if they can keep it up in the second half when we come back here on the Hedy Butova Gymnasium. As well as the 1-3 pointer that St. Mike's hit in that first half as they were 1-7 from beyond the arc. We'll see if the Jackets can keep it up in the second half and pick up a W here, or if St. Mike's has some fight in them and can make this a game. As right now, the Jackets have just ran away with it. St. Mike's dressed in purple with the gold piping alongside their shorts. I'm going left to right here in the second half. Here's Evra. These are for Godreau. Right side, Sabine. Sabine to the hoop, throws it off glass. It's blocked by Ferrantino, and Ferrantino gets the loose ball. Roach will bring it up the floor for AIC. She leave it for Mason. Mason to Stephanie. Down low to find Ferrantino. Her defender overruns the pass, and Ferrantino lays it in wide openly for the easy lay-in. Here's Evra. Finds Goodrow. Over top to Evra. Jackets pressing still. The other Sabine to cutting Baroud. She'll throw it up from the free throw line. Shot's no good off the backboard. Back iron rebound grabbed by Ferrantino, but is a held ball. As Evera gets their paws on it, it'll be Jack a ball in the change of arrow. Hold your shot, 42-18 Jackets. They start the second here. Mason, left side, Stephanie. Stephanie looking. Finds Mason at the free throw line. Now to the right baseline. Ferrantino will get it back out to Bishop. Dribble, drive, finds a cutting Mason. Oh, she travels. And it'll be a Purple Knight ball. Right side here against the press. Evra goes over the top, finds Frappier. Frappier over the top to Goodrow. Along the left sideline. Baroud. Left to Goodrow. Goodrow over the top, finds Baroud. In the corner, they get it to Evra. She'll dribble drive through the baseline, into the corner to Goodrow. Her three is up and good. Only the second three-pointer from the Purple Knights here on the game. 42-21, 18-25 to go. Roach, along the right sideline. Goes through the left around the screen. Finds Bishop, top of the arc. She'll fire for three. No good off the back iron. Rebound will go out of play, and it will be AIC ball. Stephanie looks down low to Mason. Ooh, he dribbles it off her foot. It'll go out of play. Purple Knight ball. Baroud back to Goodrow. Gets the pressure, go way over the top to Frappier, and back to Evra. Godreau along the right side. down low to Frappier. Pass is not a good one, and it goes off Perud's foot and out of play. Check and ball. .42-21, 17:50 to go. Roach, here along the left. Gives it out for Bishop. Bishop between the circles. Dumps it down low. Ferentino has position, and she lays it in off glass for two. 43-21. Jackets with 17:30 to go. Berude, oh, almost traveled. She got rid of the ball just before she did, though. And regathers for St. Mike's. Frappier's trapped at midcourt and draws a foul. As the Jackets tried to get a steal on her, it'll be Purple Knight ball. Second foul on Ferentino. First in the second half on AIC. Good drill. Into the corner. Evra. Wide open. She'll fire a three. No, she gets the friendly roll as it bounced off the rim and in the glass. And in for three. So lead down to 20. Roach along the sideline. Puts it out to Stepney. Stepney between the circles. Dumps it to Mason at the free throw line, who draws a foul. It'll be the first team foul on the Purple Knights here in the second half. And Aurora will pick up her first, or third, excuse me. Bounce pass is a bad one. Inbounds, picked up by Berude. Berude will hustle it into the forecourt and leave it back to Evora. Apkentite, here to the right side, dumb low to Evora. Along the block, she'll muscle it up and draw the foul. Good job using her body, and she'll get herself two at the line. Fouls on Mason, her second. Free throw's good. Need one more here for Evora. Hit them both. She has the last five for the Purple Knights. Lead down to 18 with 16:25 to go. Or 45 to go, excuse me. Mason, top of the key. Left side, Roach dumps it down low to Ferentino. Along the baseline, works her way to the hoop. Throws it off glass, and she gets the friendly roll. 20-point AIC lead. Goodrow back to Berude. Back to Goodrow. Over the top, finds Berude, who goes into the forecourt to Sabine. Sabine will pass right side to get it around the perimeter. And they'll finally settle it here with Berude at the free throw line. She'll get it back out. 15 on the shot clock. Evora, right side, Apkentite. Pass down low is deflected. Operud's knee and stolen by Ferentino. It's either for Roach, who can't handle it. And here comes Sabine. Over the top, a bit too high, looking for Berude, and it's turned over to AIC. Bunch of substitutions coming down for St. Mike's as Roach will bring it into the forecourt. Crosses the timeline. Here to the left side, Stepney. Stepney goes to her right around a screen, holding up here near the top of the arc. Gets it to Bishop. Along the baseline, Ferentino. Pumps, drives, throws up the runner. It's a little bit short. Rebound to Bennett. And Berude will bring it up. Here's for Bennett. Bennett will dribble in, kicks out to Apkentite. Apkentite, here to the left side. Berude, dribble, drive, throws it up along the run. It's no good. Rebounded in the hands of Tepley. Roach. Here for Tepley. Tepley hands it off to Stepney. Stepney bounces it. Ferentino, baseline jumper's good. Good from about 15 away, and it's a 22-point AIC lead. Berude. The backcourt. This is a Blanche. Blanche will find Apkentite. Goes down the lane, lost the handle. Picked up by Bennett. Along the baseline, she'll kick it out Berude. Bounces to Evra. Swings the left side to Blanche. little slow on the swing and didn't able to get a shot off. Right side, Bennett, she travels. And it'll be jack and ball. Right side, Roach. I got a foul. It's going to be on Bennett as Tepler's trying to get inside to get some position. Second team foul on the Purple Knights. The second on Bennett. Roach. Lower right baseline. Looking. Pat finds Ferentino. Takes three dribbles in. Down the lane. Muscles it up. No good. Rebound tipped and in the hands. Oh, but a pass is stolen by Roach. Great job. Finds Ferentino. Baseline jumper is a little short. A rebound picked up by Abkintade. Under 14 to go now. Goodrow. Top of the key to Abkintade. Left side, Baroud. Dumps it down low to Bennett. Working her way into the paint. Right-handed hook is way off the mark. Rebound, Baroud. And she'll get another opportunity here for the Knights. Goodrow. Pull up, 20-footer is way short. Rebound, Stepney. Roach, along the right sideline. Bouncing into the corner, Ferentino. Back to Roach. Ferentino wants it. She gets it along the block. Makes her move. Goes up a little off the mark. Rebound, Tepley. Kicks out, Roach. Pumps. Pull up along the right lane is no good. Rebound, Baroud. Right side, Goodrow. Up ahead to Abkindite. And they beat the Jackets down the floor for a deuce. And Coach Hancock, or Kynock, will take a timeout. As the lead down to 20, 48-28 with 13:08 to go. And Jackets getting a little lazy there, and I assume Coach Sosa is going to come in there for Coach Hutchinson. She's not gonna be happy with the lack of hustle there on that last possession. Even though the Jackets are up by 20, got to finish the business here with 13:08 to go. Purple Knights don't want to go away quietly. Bishop up the right sideline as they come out of the timeout to find Holland, top of the key. She bounces it along the lane. And a move is made by Mason. She can't get it to fall. Rebound, Goodrow. Baroud into the right corner. And they'll get it back out to Goodrow. Appendine gets it into Sabine. Down in the paint, up strong, a little bit off the mark. Rebound, loose, muscle tussle. Baroud gets it. It goes out of play. She was on the sideline, or baseline, so it'll go to AIC. There's Bishop. Bounces here to the right side, Easter. She fouls a foul on Baroud. 13 foul on St. Mike's here in the second half. Baroud will pick up her second. Easter finds Holland in the corner. Back out to Bishop. Bishop between the circles, a claw out of play. Left side finds Dorsett. Now to Holland. Top of the key, Mason. Mason, dribble, drive, down the right part of the lane, muscles it up, a bit short, rebound Frappier. Evora crosses the timeline. Gives it here to the left side. Blotch. Top of the key, Goodrow. Jackets man-to-man as they get here to the right to Evora. Evora goes up high. Down low to Sabine. She'll kick it out. Way out to Goodrow. Can't handle the pass. And it'll be AIC ball on the turnover. Right side. I'll pass it to Easter. Top of the key. And they swing it here to the left to Holland. Holland gets it down low to Dorsett. In the paint. Little four-footer, and she bangs it home. 50-28 with 11:30 to go. Dorsett having one of her better games. There's Goodrow. 8 points here for Dorsett. Dump it down low to Frappier. She'll draw a foul on Mason. No, no, they're going to be offensive foul. On Frappier. Shows to use the hook to get open. 11:16 to go. It's 50-28. AIC leading with the basketball. Bishop along the right sideline. Bounced it to Holland, top of the arc. Holland a look. Leaves it for Easter. Easter left to right, down the lane. Finger roll is way off the mark. Rebound grabbed by Evora. Trying to go down the floor quickly. She'll find Baruth, throws it up along the baseline. Shot's no good. Goes up again and is blocked, but she draws a foul. It'll be on Mason. And two shots for Baruth. Free throw's good. One more for Baruth. Second free throw is good as well. So 50-30 with 10:48 to go. Roach. Into the forecourt. Hands off to Mason. Now to the left side, Easter. Easter goes to her right, around a couple of screens. Here's it up for Holland. Holland spins down the lane. Last to handle, regathered. Kicks it out to Roach. Can't handle it. It'll go into the backcourt, and it'll be a backcourt violation. Stephanie's going to come onto the floor for AIC. 20-point lead with 10:23 to go for the Jackets. Goodrow. Into the corner to Evora. Back to Goodrow. Baruth. Dribble. Drive. Jump stop. Throws it off glass and she hits the runner.
Mackenzie
Baruth. 50-32. Roach. Find Stephanie along the right. Take a few dribbles. Powers her way in. Picks up her dribble. Gets it out to Dorsett. And she'll bring it out beyond the arc. Back to Roach. 10 on the shot clock. Roach. Dutters. Dribble. Drive. Down the left part of the lane. Shot short. Rebound. Mason. Her putback is good. Coach Hutchinson will take a timeout. Give her ladies a little time to relax and get some more words in there with 9:37 to go. Still a 20-point game, 52-32 for AIC as they have dominated the Purple Knights here today. A loss would drop the Purple Knights to 3-10 in the conference, 8-10 overall. A win would help propel the Jackets to 6-7 in the NE10, one game away from 500. And 11-10 overall, so a game over 500 in the overall standings. Scheduled is another one that the Jackets should win coming up. This weekend they'll take on St. Anselm away from home, but a team that the Jackets should be able to beat. They beat them earlier this year by 26. Then they'll play St. Rose, who is another one of those teams that they should beat at the bottom of the Southwest Conference at 4-8. That'll be away from home as well. They beat St. Rose earlier this year by 8. They'll have Pace, another one that they should win, so they should be able to get, could be able to get 4 wins in a row, which would propel their record of 9-7 in the conference before they play Adelphi, who is one of the better teams in the country. Of course, then they got New Haven, Lemoyne, and Southern, all some of the better teams in the conference, particularly in their conference. 3 is no good, and Bishop gets the board. So the Jackets got to get the wins here while they can, because down the stretch, it will be difficult in the final 4 games. 9-9 to go, Jackets by 20. Here's Roach. Bishop, excuse me. She'll bounce to Ferentino. Baseline jumper is an air ball. Rebound into the hands of Bennett. That's an uncharacteristic shot for her. I think she just had a little too much of an open look on that time. Evora. They're along the left side by the three-point arc. Finds Baruch. She'll step to her right and fire the three. Shot's well off the mark, and the rebound's picked up by Bishop. Roach pushes it down the floor. Throws it up high along the right, and the foul from behind is committed on Ferentino. Be the 15th foul on the Purple Knights, and it'll be jack and ball. Akintetide will pick up the foul. 15th foul, her third. Going to Ferentino from the right part of the lane. Spins it in the basket. From the block, he'll get it off glass for two. 54-32. Baroud, right side, Goodrow. Up over at top, find Bennett. Bennett to the hoop and into the corner finds Akindate. She'll fire the three. It's long and the rebound picked up by the Jackets. Gonna have a whistle. Looks like Akindate may have came down a little gingerly and the official noticed that and allowed her to go to the bench. As they'll make the substitution, it'll be AIC ball. 8-9 to go. Jackets by 22. Roach along the right sideline. Dribble, drive. The runner is short. The rebound in the hands though, Roach, who leans in and with her left hand puts it off glass for 2 points. 56-32. Goodrow finds Sabine over the top, right side Evora. Evora dribble, drive along the right side, all the way around the paint and to the opposite sideline. Not a good draw. Left side, Evora wide open. She'll fire for three and she hits. 56-35 with 7:33. Roach between the circles. She'll hand it to Ferentino. Over the top, right side, back to Roach. Jackets send some screens. Again, down low to Ferentino. We have a whistle away from the ball. It'll be a holding foul on the Purple Knights. It'll be on Sabine, her first. Get in to Tepley, lower right block. They left her wide open, and she lays it in for two. Mixed up on the switches. And it's a 23-point AIC lead now. Sabine here to the left side. Now they dump it to Baroud at the free throw line. Steps in, pulls up. 8-footer is a bit long. Rebound grabbed by the Jackets. Stepney will hand it to Roach over the top. Quickly to the left side, Ferentino. Makes him move into the paint and gets it back out to Roach. Mallet, top of the key, finds Stepney. Stepney dribble drive there to the left. Roach, she'll fire for three from the hash. It's short, rebound of Baroud. Baroud, quickly to the left side, Goodrow. Down low, Bennett along the block. We'll draw the foul on the floor. Well, a 14th foul on AIC.
Yellow jacket foul number 32. Simply her first personal, fourth on the team.
First foul on Tepley. Good drill. Left baseline will find Sabine. Making her move in the paint. Fades away and draws a foul. We got herself two at the line.
Yellow jacket foul on number 30.
It's on Easter. The second foul on Easter. Only the 15 foul. Free throw from Sabine is good. She'll get one more. Second free throw is in and out. No good. Rebound tipped out of play. It'll be jacket ball. 6:20 to go. It's 58-36. Jackets by 22. In the backcourt against the press, it's a 2-2-1 zone. They go over the top. They find Ferentino, who will just walk away and eat some clock. Roach. Easter in the corner to Ferentino. 13 on the shot clock. Back to Roach. Easter, right side, Mallet. Finds Ferentino. 21-footer is a little bit short. A rebound picked up by Blatch, who picks up the foul on Mallet. Her first, the team's sixth.
Yellow jacket foul on number 4, Crystal Mallet. First personal, sixth on the team.
There you go, Blatch. Swinging it to the left side, Goodrow. Check out the Blatch. Right side, Bennett. Bennett to Blatch, 50 on the shot clock. Left side, Baroud. To dump it into Sabine. Power dribble off the left block, and she banks it home for two more. Lead down to 20 with 5:24 to go. Roach into the right corner finds Mallet. Mallet, 3 feet dribbles, leaves it for Easter. Easter looking, leaves it for Roach. Roach going to go to her right around the screen. Down the right part of the lane. Muscles it up as it's stripped. But there's a lot of play and it'll stay jack of ball. 7 on the shot clock. Be Bishop to pass it in. Goes over the top and finds Holland. Holland to the paint. Nice pass and Mason. Oh, misses the wide open lane. Baroud will slow it down. Cross court, left side to Gaudreau. In the corner, Sabine. Finally dribbles, goes up high. Frappier makes her move to the paint, and her shot is off the mark. Rebound, Ferentino. Bishop dribbles to the right sideline. Hands off to Ferentino. Ferentino to the left, finds Easter. Dribbles in, powers her way in, and lays it in for two. 60-38. There's 4:21 to go in the game. Frappier at the free throw line. Goes down low to Sabine. She can't handle it and loses it out of play as we jack a ball in the turnover. Purple Knights struggling offensively here today. Only 38 points and we still have only 4 minutes and 15 seconds to go. Holland here along the left. She'll dump it down low to Ferentino. From the low left block, turns into the center paint, kicks it out. Easter finds Ferentino, lost their handle on the way to the paint. I guess they had a jump ball. This one will go to the Purple Knights with 3:45 to go. Get down low to Sabine, who is fouled, and she'll get herself two more at the free throw line.
Yellow jacket foul on number 30, Ebony Easter, her third personal, seventh on the team. At the line for St. Michael, shooting 1-1, number 20, Maggie Sabine.
Free throw from Sabine is no good. Rebound by Mason. Bishop. In the forecourt, crosses over, spins, kicks out right side to Mason. Take a few dribbles. Trying to make her way down the right part of the lane, but she travels. And it'll be a Purple Knight ball. Mallet and Dorsett check in for the Jackets. Just over 3 minutes here is Blatch into the forecourt. Right side, Baroud. Okay, it's a Gaudreau. Gaudreau, left side, Blatch. Blatch finds a cutter, down low to Bennett. Ball is deflected. It'll be a foul and a one-on-one opportunity for Bennett.
Yellow Jacket foul. Eighth on the team.
Fourth foul on Easter. Free throw from Bennett is good. And should get one more. Second is good as well. 60-40 with 3:05 to go. Right side, Easter. Easter goes to Stepney, now to the left side, Mallet. Mallet looking into the corner to Holland. Holland dribble, drive along the baseline, reverse lane is an air ball, and the rebound's grabbed by the Knights. Goodrow. Down low, finds Boudreaux, who will hit the shot from about 4 feet away. Okay, it's 60-42. Stepney finds Easter, left side, Mallet. Mallet almost loses it, regathers. Finds Dorsett. Dorsett, top of the arc, left side to Stepney. Into the shot clock. She makes her move to the hoop, up strong, and she lays it in off the block. 20-point lead for the Jackets. 2 minutes to go. Rude as they swing it around the perimeter. Foul down low. It'll send another 1-1 for the Purple Knights. As Dorsett will pick up the foul first. Bennett will go back to the line for 1-1. It's the free throw, and she'll get one more. It's both free throws. 62-44 is the score with 1:51 to go. Stepney, top of the key to Easter. Easter will find Holland at the free throw line. Now to the right, Stepney. Stepney, a couple dribbles, these are for Easter. 13 on the shot clock. Stepney, down low, it's deflected. Loose ball, a jump ball, it'll be AIC ball with 8 on the shot clock. Mallet, lower right baseline, looking to pass it in. In the left corner to Stepney. Stepney works her way to the hoop. Spins. Little 8-foot fadeaway is no good. A rebound into the hands of the Purple Knights. Goodrow. Is there for Blatch. Right corner to Goodrow. Back to Blatch. At the free throw line, Gurney. Gurney into the corner to Goodrow. Back to Gurney at the free throw line. Down low to Bennett, who draws a foul as she gets herself two at the free throw line. Third trip for her today at the free throw line. She's hit all four of her free throws. Hit the free throw and cuts the lead 62-45. Stephanie. Here to Mallet. Mallet dribble, drive down the lane, and hits the floater. Goodrow. Dump it down low. Find Baroon, who throws it up. Shot's no good. Rebound on the weak side by Holland. Blotch with a steal in the forecourt. 34 on the game clock. 3 on the way from Goodrow is no good. Rebound Easter. Half a minute to go. Jackets by 19. Easter. I just eat this one out now. There's about a half a second differential between game clock and shot clock. Easter. Back door set. And Mallet. Gonna fire for 3. And she hits it off glass. And that's it. The game is over. The Jackets are gonna win 64-45. With the loss, St. Mike's goes to 3-10 in the inning 10, 8-10 overall. The Jackets go to 6-7 in the conference, 11-10 overall. Nice.